They may look dead, but there is still life within these leaves. Years of drought may plague them, but nothing can stop these plants from rising again. These comeback kids may even teach us how to make the plants we eat more resistant to drought. These are the resurrection plants.
Hey, I'm Tasha the Amazon, and you're watching Floralogic. Today we're talking about desiccation-resistant plants that just don't quit.
We spend a lot of time on this channel talking about plants and animals, but we want to make sure that we aren't forgetting our viewers either. So let's take a moment to talk about mental health. If you've been having trouble sleeping, managing relationships, or even just having low self-esteem, you're not alone. I'm often staying up late thinking about all the projects I have to juggle on a daily basis. Today's sponsor, BetterHelp, is here to help you. BetterHelp offers licensed therapists who are trained to listen and help you through the toughest moments. There are more than 20,000 therapists in the BetterHelp network, giving you access to help that might not normally be available in your area. You can talk to a therapist in private, online, at your convenience, and they offer a broad range of expertise. Just fill out a questionnaire to help assess your specific needs, and you'll be matched with a therapist in under 48 hours. You can then schedule a video or phone session and exchange unlimited messages. Everything you share is completely confidential, and if you'd like, you can request a new therapist at any time at no additional charge. Get 10% off your first month at betterhelp.com/animalogic and join more than 2 million people who have taken charge of their mental health. Resurrection plants are anhydrobiotic, meaning they have the ability to come back to life after weeks, months, or even years of dehydration. The most basic aspect of plant care is that plants need water. If you have plants at home, even succulents, air plants, and other species that require little water, you know that forgetting to give them a drink for too long could spell death for your plant babies.
And plants are thirsty. Depending on the species, most plants will die if they lose more than 15% of their relative water content.
In the case of the roughly 100 resurrection plants that exist, they can tolerate losing up to 97% of their relative water content and live to see another day or even decade. When they do find water again, they come back fast and furious, rehydrating to their old selves in just a matter of hours.
But how do resurrection plants return from the brink of dehydration when other plants would have dried up and died long ago?
When faced with drought, resurrection plants enter a state called anhydrobiosis. In this state, there is almost no water within their cells, and their metabolic activity all but stops. To survive, they have to be able to not only maintain their physiological integrity, but they also have to cap the damage caused by desiccation, a fancy way of saying the removal of water, and repair damage that was suffered when water becomes available again.
Xerophyta humilis ranges from southern Ethiopia to Namibia and is a Poikilla chlorophyllis type of resurrection plant.
Desiccation-tolerant plants are divided into two types, homoiochlorophyllis, those that maintain their chlorophyll when dried out, and poikilochlorophyllis, those that lose it. Chlorophyll is the pigment that makes plants green and aids with photosynthesis, the process that plants use to turn sunlight into energy.
Losing its chlorophyll is a strategy Xerophyta humilis evolved so that it doesn't waste energy maintaining its photosynthetic system during periods of desiccation. It also means that it has to resynthesize chlorophyll when it rehydrates.
To keep stable during dry periods, organs inside the Xerophyta humilis cells, which are normally filled with water, are replaced with smaller organs filled with substances like sugars or acids. This prevents the cells from collapsing when it dries out, allowing the plant to rise again.
Let's move on to the most iconic of resurrection plants, the spike moss Salaginella lepidophylla, also known as the false rose of Jericho.
Originating from the Chihuahuan desert of Mexico and the US, this plant definitely needs to be desiccation tolerant to survive on its home turf.
False rose of Jericho is not to be confused with the true rose of Jericho, Anastatica hirochuntica, which is a tumbleweed native to Western Asia and not part of our exclusive Resurrection Plant Club.
While the genus Salaginella contains about 700 species, only three of these have evolved to become desiccation resistant. When subjected to extreme aridity, this plant curls itself up into a tight ball as its leaves dry out and become brown.
The outer leaves curl in pretty quickly, shading the inner part of the plant, while the inner leaves take it slow as the plant dries out.
Then its metabolic functions essentially stop completely. If the drought lasts long enough, the roots of the false rose of Jericho disconnect, and it will blow away in the wind, similar to a tumbleweed, until it encounters moisture, unfolds, and takes root in the new location. False roses of Jericho don't have seeds. Instead, they reproduce with spores, like ferns do.
Next on our list of plants with sequels, Haberlia rhodopensis, also known as the Orpheus flower.
This plant is native to the mountains of central and southern Bulgaria and northern Greece. This unflappable flower is named after Orpheus, a musical superhuman hero from ancient Greek mythology who was torn apart by the women of Thrace. Even after he was ripped to pieces, his head kept on singing as it floated down the river it was thrown into.
It's that never give up in the face of decapitation attitude that inspired this plant's common name.
Growing at elevations between 600 and 1700 meters, these rare jewels can be found nestled in limestone crevices. Orpheus flowers can lose up to 90% of their relative water content and still survive, although not without a few battle scars. Such extreme desiccation takes its toll on the outside leaves, but the inner crown will regenerate and new leaves will grow when moisture levels return.
Our next plant is a resurrection fern, otherwise known as Pleopeltis polypodioides, native to southern North America and Central America.
The resurrection fern is an epiphyte, which is commonly called an air plant, meaning that it lives its life attached to another plant for support. These plants get their moisture and nutrients from the air, not from the host, like in the case of parasitic plants.
I like to think of resurrection ferns as a ride or die to their tree FFs.
When they get dried out, the fronds of the resurrection fern curl up and turn gray-brown, giving it the appearance of being long dead. It can tolerate losing up to 97% of its water, and according to scientific estimates, it could remain in this death-like condition for over a century. The second it's exposed to even a small amount of moisture, new life is breathed into the fronds and it quickly returns to its former green and luscious state.
The resurrection fern is a true sleeping beauty, if sleeping beauty were a shriveled pile of brown leaves.
The resurrection fern holds the title for being the first fern in space when it was taken aboard the space shuttle Discovery in 1997 to be studied. The result? Pleopeltis polypodioides is just as efficient at returning from the brink of death, even while barreling around the Earth in zero gravity at 28,000 kilometers an hour.
So I guess you could call the resurrection fern the first space zombie.
Scientists are still trying to understand the how and why behind desiccation tolerance in resurrection plants. By studying their natural protection mechanisms, we can learn how to make crops more resistant to drought. By targeting genetic modifications, we could hack how other plants respond to extreme aridity. This would be especially important for food production in arid areas of the world, where certain crops may not be able to handle the extremely dry climate. In a climate-changing world where hotter, drier conditions are on the horizon, this type of research may even be crucial for our future.
Even though it seems they can live into eternity, resurrection plants can't stay in their desiccated state forever. Eventually, if they don't find water, even this mega-resilient plant will shrivel and die. There's a metaphor for love and connection in here somewhere, I'm sure. So what should we talk about next? Let me know in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe for new episodes every week. Peace. But how do resurrection plants, I just want to say erection plants. Defecation and erection plants. Like, that's what all the comments are going to say. Like, let's be honest here. Okay.